So how can you stop the windows in your car from misting up? It's a thing that plagues us every time the temperature outside drops. So in this video, we're just going to look at some of the physics involved, what's happening to cause our windows to mist up, and how we can exploit this phenomena to reduce the likelihood of it happening to us. So we have to talk about condensation and dew points, really. So warm air is able to carry a lot of moisture. Cold air can't carry as much moisture, so the moisture has to drop out. So what's happening inside the car? Very, very simply, there's a big technical explanation that will probably take a couple of hours to go into in detail, but all we need to know really is that you've got the warm air hitting the cold windows, so the temperature differential is effectively pulling the water out of the air and it's condensing on our windows. So what we see on our windows are tiny little droplets of water. So that very simple fact that warm air carries more moisture and cold air carries less moisture is something we can exploit and understand better. So most of us, when the windows are misted up, we will use heat. We will warm those windows up and we will evaporate off the moisture that's built up inside the windows, and effectively the air inside the car, because it's warm, it will now collect that. So you've not actually move the problem elsewhere. You've still got this moist air inside the car. And what tends to happen is we get out when it's raining, we get back in, the moisture from our clothes just adds to this moisture inside the car, and we start to have a tropical rainforest climate going on inside our car, and it's just building up. So the problem is getting worse and worse. So we said that cold air carries less moisture. So the strategy really is to exploit that to get rid of the moisture that is in the air inside the car. We can use the heat to fill the air inside the car with as much of the moisture as possible, and then we can open the windows and just vent that moist air out. Then, if we keep the temperature inside the car cooler, there'll be less moisture collecting in the air inside the car, and that will go a long way to reducing the windows from misting up. So if we do this, if we use the air conditioning as well, air conditioning itself will extract the moisture from the air before that is recirculated back into the cabin. So you might think of your air conditioner as something you only use in the summer, but a lot of people use it in the winter for the very reason of reducing the moisture out of the air that's inside the car. So other tips that people have passed on to me over the years is to keep something moisture absorbing inside the car. So someone suggested a cup of rice. We know that if you drop your phone in water, you're supposed to rush it into a cup of rice. Let me know in the comments if that's ever actually worked for you. The reality is that rice isn't that absorbent. It's not going to do a massive job at reducing the moisture inside the car. You can actually get these silica moisture traps that people put in their wardrobe to keep the moisture away from their clothes, and they can work quite effectively inside a car, particularly if the car has become damp. You've had a lot of rainy days and there's a lot of moisture that's come off of your clothes and soaked into the fabric and the seats and the carpet inside the car. So these little silica moisture traps actually work really well inside a car. They can go a long way to creating a drier atmosphere inside the car. And if the air inside the car is dry, there's very little scope for it to condense on the car windows. So is there anything that we can put on the window itself? So what these would do effectively is stop the moisture droplets from forming as droplets. So if they can break up these little bubbles or little droplets of water, you'll be able to see out of the window, so you won't have that problem. And there's a number of very specific formulations that we can buy. I think Rain-X have got an anti-fog. Let me know if you've used that. One little thing though that I found useful is just a little bit of shampoo. If you get some shampoo on a cloth and just rub it over the windscreen and then rub it off, you don't want to leave very much residue at all. It's just giving it a flavor of the shampoo, and that has proved effective at preventing the window from misting up. You can try it on half of the window and just see how you get on. Some of these coatings can actually make the window rather smeary, so you want to be careful what you specifically use. The off-the-shelf formulations are normally pretty good, but you do pay a lot of money for them. So if you've got a little tip that you'd like to pass on in the comments, something you can rub onto the window that will prevent it from misting up, please let us know so we can share that with the world. And we can all save a bit of money not buying these expensive pre-made formulations. And also avoiding just driving around with the car really, really hot. We don't want all of that heat, all of that moisture-laden hot air inside the car. So crack open a window, wrap up warm. I'm not saying to drive around in a freezing cold car, but just dropping the interior temperature of the car a few degrees can go a long way to preventing this problem. And it's not just an immediate thing when we get in. We can have a cumulative problem that just gets worse and worse as the interior of the car is trapping more and more moisture. So I hope these little tips have been useful to you. Please boot the like button. That really does help us to get out there. And I've lined this video and this playlist up for you that'll help you to get the best out of your car. Thanks for watching. See you in this next video.